Hi, it's Jen. Welcome back. I went to the Alameda Flea Market, or also known as the Alameda Point Antiques Fair. But I'm just gonna call it the flea market because it's just a lot easier for me to say. So this is the part where I'll put in the flashback of Sunday. I'm on my way to the Alameda Flea Market right now, and the Alameda Flea Market is basically an antique fair that happens every first Sunday of the month, and today happens to be the first Sunday of September. I'm looking for a home decor stuff because my house is cool, but it's lacking, you know, some interest, some quirkiness, so I'm just gonna find little knickknacks to put in my house, hopefully a vanity, but that's maybe asking for too much. Let's see what happens. Status update, it's around 1 o'clock. We only got a few knickknacks, no luck on the vanity, no luck on a bed dresser thing. Everything's really overpriced, which is kind of a bummer, but spirits are okay. Is this too depressing to use? It is. I'm just being honest. It's just rows upon rows of just stuff, and you don't know if you're getting a good deal or not, because the next thing that's similar to that thing, you already lost your place. So maybe if we made like a map of the entire thing, it would be a little bit more efficient, but ain't nobody got time for that. I think we're gonna do one more walk around to see if there's anything else, but other than that, that's a wrap, I guess. I just really wanted to get a vanity. All right, peace out. Beep. Okay, so now that's out of the way, here are the things that I bought at the flea market. I got this fossilized trilobite, and this thing is around 500 million years old. And so I thought that it would be a good reminder for me to realize that the earth didn't start when I was born, and it's not gonna end while I'm dead either. So it just kind of puts me on check, because sometimes it's really easy to just get really lost in your own world and become very egotistical about your goals and become very selfish. But to realize that we're just only a slither in one huge picture that our brains can't even fathom is something that is going to keep us all humble and down to earth. So I thought this would be a good reminder for me, and plus I think the color scheme is really sick because it's gonna go in with my room. I'm all about storage, and prior to this thing I'm about to show you, all my lipsticks were just kind of laid out in this gross shoddy bag. So, I mean, I'm pretty sure I've lost at least 6 to 10 lipsticks just because I just threw them in my bag, or I've washed them in the washer because I left them in my pocket. So when I saw this metal basket, the only thing I saw was a lipstick container. It's supposed to be an old toolbox or something, or painters can use it to kind of hold up all their brushes, but I'm gonna use it to store all my lipsticks because it's just the perfect size for all the little tubes. I just love the whole old derelict element of it, and I tried my best to wipe it down with a Clorox wipe and kind of hose it down, but I honestly think that this is as clean as it's gonna get. And plus, I think it's not too bad because I've done the best I could, and all the lipsticks are self-contained, so I don't think there's gonna be any crazy contamination at this point. So my next item is this silver structure, which was once part of a giant mixing contraption, I suppose, but I'm gonna use it as a candle holder because the hole right here happens to be perfect for candle fitting. I've already ordered some rainbow candles to put in here, so I'm very, very excited about that. And I just think it looks like an old art deco piece, which is gonna look sick in my room. I bought one piece of jewelry, and it is the silver watch. It's broken, but I think it's mostly gonna be for looks anyway. I love how dainty it looks all by itself, and I think it looks amazing when I stack other bracelets with it, with kind of other silver bracelets or bracelets with a pop of turquoise. I think it's just a good piece to mix and match with. So my next piece is a little bit strange, but don't call her creepy because I think she can hear. When I first saw her, I just thought she was so beautiful. I bought her so I can just kind of display my hats in a fun and unique way, and I think she looks damn good in every single one of my hats. For now, I put her in this little captain's hat because I'm kind of liking that whole military look right now, so she's gonna wear this. I personally don't think she's creepy because she's never directly looking at you. She's always just kind of spacing out and in a really nice daydream, which I wish that I can see. I've yet to give her a name, so if you have any suggestions, please comment down below and I would love to pick out my favorite one. So my last piece is a vanity. I actually got one. I was stunned, but I ran into it towards the end of the flea market. It's this old wooden wicker table, and I just love the fact that the wood has kind of evolved into all these different types of colors. There's different shades of brown and hints of green to it, so it just really kind of ties in my whole room together by making it a little bit more warm, cozy, and a little bit rustic too. I still have to get a mirror for it and a chair as well, so I mean, it's still a work in progress, but for now, it is perfect. Before I leave, I wanted to mention that I'm having a free meet and greet for everybody on September 6th in New York, and the time and the location is still yet to be made, but if you follow Sugar and Fluff and Thread Sense on Instagram or Twitter, they're gonna announce it there. They're the ones who are organizing the entire event, so they're the ones who are getting the news first, and so if you just follow them on Twitter or Instagram, you'll have the details first. Also, if you have a Snapchat, you can follow ThreadSense for little snippets of my party and the meet and greet and just little cute messages in general. I'll also put the info to the Alameda Flea Market or the Antiques Fair in the description box in case you're wondering where it was and if you already forgot what day it's on. If you have an Instagram or Twitter, my handle is imjenim for both accounts, so you can follow me there if you'd like. I hope you all had a relaxing and wonderful Labor Day. I know I did. I just spent most of my time kind of putting my place together, and I also went to the beach. I went to Half Moon Bay, and it was wonderful to just kind of soak in the sun, read and play frisbee. My right wrist is so sore from throwing it. If you like seeing these videos, just kind of home decor slash knickknack things, then I would love it if you'd give it a thumbs up. It'd mean a lot to me. And other than that, I will see you guys next time, and thank you so much for watching. Bye! Yeah. Hi everyone, it's Jen. Today I'm going to take some summer outfits and then transition them into full-blown fall ensembles. So I hope you guys enjoy. I'm starting things off with the classic romper. And I love wearing ones that are just in a super soft and loose material because it really helps the breeze and they're just really comfy to wear. I paired this one with some minimalist black sandals from Zara, and then to kind of bring it up a notch, I am wearing these chandelier earrings that are totally iridescent and wicked. In order to make it more fall appropriate, I just added a bunch of black elements to my look. I thought this shredded black hoodie was the piece to layer over the romper, because now the romper just looks like it's just an ordinary pair of shorts. And I added some dot tights to cover up my legs. And then I wore these huge, massive, semi-patent Jeffrey Campbells from Pixie Market. tie-dye or psychedelic prints were such a huge trend in the summer. This top is more of a watercolor print, and it reminds me a lot of the ocean because of the depth it has. To enhance the blue colors of the shirt, I paired it with my blue pleather axle shorts, and then I slipped into these taupe ankle boots from Zara to just kind of mute the bottom half of my look. I threw on a pair of sunglasses because no summer look is complete without them. For my fall version, once again, I just added a bunch of black layers and some winter textures. I just threw on a thin black cardigan in case it gets a little bit chilly. And then I just added some black pleather pants to toughen it up and make it a little bit more badass. Whenever I wear a Hawaiian shirt, I just can't help but feel like a dorky tourist. Well, a dorky yet stylish tourist. And this one is great because it's cropped, fitted, and it has a simple color palette. And I wanted the white in the shirt to really, really pop, so I added my white lace trim high-waisted shorts. I wore some old beat-up Converse that I got as a hand-me-down from my old roommate, and I like how she already pre-broken them in, so it's great. And now I'm showing you how you can wear a Hawaiian shirt in the fall. It's pretty easy. Same method, add a bunch of dark colors and warm knits. And I'm so stoked to be wearing speckled knits again because they're my favorite print for the colder weather. I traded in the Converse for these thrifted cream Oxfords because I just feel like they're a lot more wintry. Alright, so I'm finishing off the video with an overall. I had my eye on these marbled overalls since June, and I kind of glossed over it when I saw the original price. They finally went on sale online, and I snatched them up because I've never seen a pair like these before, and I took my chance when the opportunity struck. And for my summer look, I just added a plain white tank with some blue embroideredness on the top, and then I just went for one of my go-to sandals. This is my fall look, and to be honest, I much prefer this way, like the way it's styled here, because I think the marble print really pops when I wear it with black. I think it makes for a really fantastic contrast. To cover up, I added some sheer swirl tights from American Apparel and a beanie. Duh. Show me how the love won't turn on me. Show me how it lovely. I hope you guys enjoyed the outfits. I'm sorry about the sloppy setup. I am currently packing for New York Fashion Week, and of course I decided to pack all my things a few hours before my flight. I am a damn fool. But I am vlogging the entire New York experience, so stay tuned for that. If you want some, I don't know, more early updates of my New York trip, you can follow me at I'm Jen Im, which is my Instagram, and you can see pictures there. Until next time, I'll see you guys later. Bye!